Hello and welcome to the first video tutorial in this introduction to quantum mechanics. My name's Justin and I'm going to talk a little bit about black body radiation. So if we were to consider any normal everyday object with some radiation incident upon it, some of that radiation will be reflected away and some will be absorbed as thermal energy. Now, if we think of some hypothetical material that doesn't reflect any of this radiation, then what we have essentially is a black body. So this material is a perfect absorber, will absorb all the energy incident upon it, and it will emit all that energy as well. But if we think about this material enclosed in an insulated box, and this box has the special property that it allows radiation in but doesn't allow it out, we can bombard this box with all different wavelengths of radiation. It will be absorbed through the box and into the black body material. It can't escape, so the temperature will rise. Now if we let that get up to some high temperature, we're going to say we'll let it get up to about 6000 Kelvin, a really high temperature, and then place a hole in this box and let that radiation escape. What will we see here? Well, this led to steffan-boltzmann's law. Essentially just says that the intensity of this radiation being emitted from the black body is proportional to the fourth power of the temperature. And this is the constant of proportionality, the Steffan-Boltzmann constant. It's not a fundamental constant. So what this is saying essentially is that if we have the intensity on this y-axis and the frequency on the x-axis, then for every temperature, or let's say we start with 6000 Kelvin here and let that temperature fall to 5000, 4000, 3000, we have, across the frequency range, we have a straight line. The curve is a straight line. So in other words, all the wavelengths of radiation we put in here, we shall see coming out here at any given temperature. Now, this isn't correct. The graph looks something more like this. I'll try and draw this. Just won't be too tidy. Frequency on the x-axis here, and the intensity on the y-axis here. This represents a temperature of 6000 Kelvin, 5000 Kelvin, 4000, 3000. And what we see is that for a given temperature, what we see is that the peak intensity of radiation falls at some specific frequency, like so. And the displacement of these curves was described by Wein's displacement law. Wein's displacement law. Now, if I just, I'll just change my color. Let's say this is the visible range, this is the infrared range, and this is the UV. What we see is, just change my color again. These areas of peak intensity, these curves of peak intensity, if we follow that, we see that it keeps going and doesn't really ever get into the UV. This was known as the ultraviolet catastrophe, and it's really spelled the end for classical physics. Now, Wein's displacement law worked really well. It described this graph really well at high frequencies, high temperatures. But it begins to break down when we get to the lower temperatures and longer wavelengths. And Max Planck was thinking about this. And in an effort to improve on Wein's displacement law, which is now known really as Wein's approximation, because that's what it was a good approximation, Max Planck was able to come up with his own laws, or his own law, should I say, called Planck's law. And he did this by thinking about, energy in a different way. So at the time, energy was considered to be a continuous entity, something that was behaves like a wave, it keeps going, and you can divide it infinitely. But Planck thought about it in a different way. He thought that, well, what if it wasn't like that? What if we could divide this energy up and keep on going, but at some point we will reach an amount of energy that cannot be divided any further? In other words, the energy is quantized or exists in packets. And what he said was that the energy was proportional to the frequency, or equal to the frequency, and times by the constant of proportionality, h here, which is Planck's constant. So h is Planck's constant, and we'll be seeing a lot more of that. It has a value of 6.626 times 10 to the minus 34 joules. So, by thinking about it in this way, Max Planck was able to derive his law, which gave a really, really good description at all frequencies, at all temperatures. And this led to some nice descriptions about, I think it was about 5 years after Max Planck sort of derived his law, Einstein was thinking about the problem of the photoelectric effect. And there was also some other observed phenomena around at the time, like constant scattering, and it was able to provide a good explanation for that as well. Now, I think I'm running out of time, so we'll discuss those phenomena in the next video.